Miss Abud, can we not get our little grad ceremony?
Literally, miss. The only thing we want is a small get-together of 250 people. It'll be fine. We'll just have a little dinner, a little party, a little cap and gown moment, and we're done.
So there's no way we're getting the diplomatic club. Well, we want something. I'm sure you understand. No grad, no gowns, nothing. I guess everybody said no cap too much.
All right, miss. Thank you anyways. It's fine.
Have a good day, miss. Bye-bye.
What if there is a way?
Maybe there is a way.
Okay, grads, let's get ready.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. Like a go country, grab and buy. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, white rum, fizzy pop. Where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. But my life trash, man it's so tough.
Alright yo, put the belly on the body, make a catch. Seen her watch, now she wanna give up. Boy got peas, now she hopping in the pod. Man a real life, sugar gal, and my forget what. When she want dark, told her meet me at the top. Switching lanes the other day, I seen her waiting for a bus. Maybe this a Moncler sweater, diesel denim. Buy another one, my pockets fat like heather. Neck froze like I don't know no better. Benzo truck, white seats and they leather. Go broke never, on my grind. She make it click like I'm Busta Rhymes. I got the juice, the sauce and all them things. I've mad her twice a night with all my bling. Big Ben I drive, I brought that thing. Any girl you want, they want my thing.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. Like I go country, grab and buy. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, white rum, fizzy pop. Where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. That's my trash, man it's so tough. Flood my eyes, make a whole blush. Back of the tour bus, getting cool up. D square, got them de-stressed. Got a hand wash, new racks with the old Nikes in the shoebox. Keep my stripes, no cuss. Pull up in a new plate, then she might just. She went tryna move bait when her eyes locked. New tints on her coupe, that's a head loss. Off my whites, right my wrongs. Gucci my mum, why you to do your thumbs? Count my sums, this is gonna get long. Love my green, I'm tryna get strong. Tryna get on, where I'm from, it's on, yes. Man don't take no dumb threats. They see funds, they hop fence. We been up, not up, next. Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. Like I go country, grab and buy. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, white rum, fizzy pop. Where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. The man is trash, man it's so tough.
Introduce him. The one and only. Big chop, no clutch. Wrist rolls, don't touch. French Siri, I'm so drunk. Cause I can't drink and drive, where's my chauffeur? Man, the whops off, whip the off. I really hold this time I work, I don't flossy. I was in the works, now my penthouse at the top. Shay said they're best friends, I bet they both. As they both cost, cause they said I sold. And when you're down, ain't nobody around. Once they come back, when you blow up. I forgot my jacket, but my heated seats help me warm up. First train to Inverary, I used to go up. It's ironic, I just sold out my show in Scotland. Used to say I wanna put Tottenham on a map, but one day I'ma change the map in Tottenham.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. Like I go country, grab and buy. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, white rum, fizzy pop. Where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. That's my good time, man it's so tough.
Teachers, parents, friends, family, and most importantly, class of 2020. Welcome to the first ever Blyth Academy Qatar virtual graduation ceremony.
We are honored to have you witness the achievements of this year's graduating class. Although this may not have been what was expected, we assure you recognition of the amazing BAQ graduating class of Qatar.
We hope you enjoy today's program. The next few speakers have been able to manage the school and have all had a vital role in overcoming several obstacles. And without further ado, we would like to welcome Mrs. Sullivan to the screen.
Welcome, graduating class, parents, teachers, Canadian Ambassador McCollum, and other family and faculty to our first and hopefully only virtual graduation celebration. A huge congratulations to our 24 Blyth Academy Qatar graduates this year. I know that this is certainly not the kind of graduation ceremony that you had predicted or hoped for, but it is one that is unique and special, as each and every one of you are. I want you to enjoy and embrace this time in your lives because you've earned it. You have often been described this year as a class of high achievers, and this has been evident not only by your academic achievements, but also your involvement in things like the Model United Nations conferences, the math competition, and other school-wide initiatives. Not to mention that two of you, and you know who you are, actually achieved 100% on an earlier diploma exam, which is no easy feat. As June 2020 high school graduates, you have had to endure what no other previous graduating class has had to. You have all managed to stay strong and complete your courses within the confines of your homes for the past 3 months during a global pandemic. And now you are receiving your diplomas. I only wish I could hand them to you in person. I'm so proud of you. This was no easy task and just goes to show what you can accomplish when faced with an unexpected challenge. At this point, it appears that most post-secondary institutions will continue to conduct classes online during the fall, so you can apply these skills you've acquired over the past 3 months to this next phase. Little did you know, you were actually being prepared for this. You are now ready for adulthood and to take on new challenges as you continue your life and educational journeys. Please do this while remaining true to yourself and never give up on your dreams and aspirations. Each and every one of you have shown that you have the potential, skill set, knowledge, and experience to take on the world and fulfill some of your dreams. Go for it. You will need to build a support system around you and become part of a new community, one in which you feel safe, cared for, respected, and happy to be a part of. Make a difference wherever you end up, short or long term. Please be sure to find and keep a balance in your study and home life and have some fun along the way, as post-secondary can be some of the best years of your life. Embrace the challenges and hardships with strength and gusto and never give up. Seek help from those you trust and do the best you can. Gravitate and cultivate positivity in your life and always, always be kind. It would be remiss of me to not mention some of the ongoing and crucial movements that are taking place and are so prevalent around the world today. Not just the fact that we are in the middle of a pandemic and so desperately need a vaccine, but other important issues like the effects of global warming and climate change, continued hunger and famine in some countries, and of course, the Black Lives Matter protests, highlighting that we continue to live in an era of racism, discrimination, and social injustice. As quoted by Nelson Mandela, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. As a newly graduating generation, you now have the power to make a difference and fight for change. This is your future, so speak up, speak out, and be involved in peaceful protests that will impact your future and an overall more peaceful and respectful world. A big shout out now to our high school teachers this year who helped prepare all of you for this day. A huge thank you as well to our guidance counselor, Ms. Heather, for all her support, guidance, counseling, encouragement, phone calls home, and sound advice in getting you here. You could not have done this without their endless caring and support. So please take a moment and thank them as well. I'd also like to thank Ms. Aboud, Miss Sophia, and the graduation committee of Reva, Elias, Eamon, Rawand, and Aya, who put so much time and energy into planning this special video and virtual event. It will be a fantastic memory that can now be viewed repeatedly for many years to come. A lovely keepsake and reminder of how your high school days ended and how your next chapter began. So again, congratulations to all of you, all the best, and please keep in touch or come back and visit us at our new campus whenever you can. Cheers, everybody.
Thank you, Mrs. Sullivan. I can assure you that our generation will definitely have a lasting impact on everybody's lives.
It also makes us realize how much we'll miss having your support and advice. We can't wait to visit you again in September.
Our upcoming guest is the current owner of Blyth Academy Qatar. Please welcome Mr. Sam Blyth.
Congratulations to the class of 2020 on their graduation from Blyth Qatar. We here in Canada are thinking of you at this difficult time and looking forward to watching your success in the years to come. And to the rest of the students at Blyth Qatar, congratulations on finding your way through a difficult year and getting to the end. We look forward to seeing you next year under new management and with strong leadership to make Blyth Qatar a better and better school. Congratulations, and thanks to all of the staff and faculty for a great year.
Thank you for your kind words, Mr. Blyth. Now, we would like to introduce Mr. Patrick Shaw, manager of Blyth Academy.
Hello, everyone. My name is Patrick Shaw. I am the managing director of Blyth Academy Qatar. I am delighted to be joining you for this very special virtual ceremony, all the way from Canada. I want to congratulate you all on this wonderful achievement and especially acknowledge the uniqueness of this online format. Please enjoy it as best you can. Stay safe, stay strong, and enjoy the wonderful futures that are ahead of you. With my very best regards, thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Shaw. We would like to hear from Mrs. Kathy Young, the Academic Director at Blyth Academy Qatar.
Hello, my name is Kathy Young. I'm the Chief Academic Officer of Blyth Academy. In my 35 years as an educator, I have participated in many commencements and graduations. I have watched hundreds of students graduate and seen their pride as well as the pride of their friends and their families who supported them along their paths. I have listened to many, much wiser than me, share their wisdom and life lessons to help the graduates make the transition to the next stage of their lives. Today, on behalf of Blyth Academy, I would like to share brief thoughts with you, the class of 2020, to help you on your way. Graduates, you are entering a world filled with uncertainty. Embrace that uncertainty. Be aware that this phase will come to an end. An exciting future does wait for you. Remember Dr. Seuss, Oh, the Places You'll Go? It's a lovely little story about setting out into the world, facing uncertainty, navigating the ups and downs, the unmarked paths, and coming out the other side. I love its conclusion, and it's my message to you today. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. On behalf of Blyth Academy Head Office in Toronto, congratulations, Blyth Academy graduates of 2020.
Thank you, Mrs. Young.
For our next honorable speaker, we would like to invite somebody very special.
She came earlier in the school year and gave a wonderful speech to the school and even answered our 100 questions and gave us some pivotal advice.
Ambassador McCallum, we would like to welcome you once again, this time not onto the stage, but onto the screen.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Stéphanie McCallum et je suis l'ambassadrice du Canada auprès de l'État du Qatar. Congratulations, Blyth graduating class of 2020. I wish I could be celebrating with you in person. I wish this was a year of normal celebrations for graduating classes such as yours, but unfortunately it's not. You know better than anyone how your class and other graduating classes around the world have been thrown a little bit into chaos by this pandemic that the world hasn't seen in recent times, and certainly that this generation hasn't seen or had to live through. So you will be remembered in history as a graduating class that had to face these unique circumstances, and you persevered. Your teachers tell me that you all did extremely well on your exams and your results this year, including two perfect scores, results that have made your teachers and your parents very proud. I've heard that many of you are going to be going on to study at universities in Canada, which makes me very happy. Anyways, I just wanted to take some time to wish you all the very best, to congratulate you on these amazing achievements. I hope you take the time to celebrate in whatever safe, non-traditional way you've come up with. Celebrate this achievement, celebrate the exciting times that await you as you go on to study, get a degree, and then start your careers out in this new world that awaits us. All the best, congratulations, bonne chance, et félicitations.
Ambassador, that was incredible. Your words never fail to leave us inspired to change the world and do good. Thank you for that. Now, for our next up speaker, I would like to call Ms. Abu to introduce them. Hello? Ms. Abu? Yes, I'm using a real phone. Can you come introduce the new speaker? Thank you.
Hello? Hello? Oh yeah, gotta record that video. I'll get on that. Thanks for reminding me. Bye. Now for our award ceremony. I will be starting our award ceremony with two non-academic awards. So for the first one, the valedictorian award goes to the student who has positively contributed to the school community and has maintained a high academic standing. He was the head boy of the school. He has completed his Duke of Edinburgh certificate, has received honorable mention at Georgetown's Model United Nations while representing the school. He has organized and has helped in most school events this year and in previous years, and has continued to maintain a high level of achievement in all of his classes. I'd like to give this award to Elias Al-Tabarani.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. 2020 has been a year of growth and nourishment for us, one way or another. The hardships that we face along the way are nothing but lessons that we should learn from for future experiences. In the short time that some of us have spent together, we have created bonds between us like no other. We, like billions of others of people out there, are learning to adapt to the environments around us during these difficult times. But the difference between us is how we choose to adapt. I wholeheartedly believe that the class of 2020 has, without a doubt, some of the most talented groups of people I have ever met. In the most humble way possible, I truly believe our class is bound to achieve even greater things than what we have already achieved because of how sophisticated and skillful our class is, whether it's in music or art, literature, the sciences, math, public speaking, sports, or even emotional strength. Every single one of us is a master in our own God-given talent. Out of the numerous messages I want to deliver, the utmost important piece of advice I want to give everybody is that we, as a generation with unlimited access to resources, should learn to invest in ourselves, dig deep into our own minds, and search for the greatness that we hold. You must live your success and be your success. Don't let your talents be wasted by carelessly taking a path you weren't meant to take. Invest time and money into yourselves, because effort and hard work spent bettering yourself and setting yourself apart from everyone else is how we'll get the opportunities to stand out in the highly competitive future ahead of us. If I didn't take chances on my own expense, I wouldn't have been able to achieve what I've achieved today. I would still be anxious to speak in front of a crowd. I'd still be afraid of losing money or leading a team. I'd still be afraid of trying out new hobbies, fearing that I won't master them. And the one that I value the most, I would still have been the average student on the second row with nothing of value to present to the table. If you're not willing to lose in order to win, you will never see the potential that is stored within you. Chemistry pun intended. If there's one person who knows what you deserve best, it's you. You are your own source of greatness, but the only limit there is to you is yourself. Do not be scared to fail, and always take that leap of faith that will take you to greater levels in life. Be comfortable with being uncomfortable, and know how to overcome your fear of losing, because that is the only way you will be able to take every chance presented to you. You must have faith in God that you will always be blessed and supported on your journey to success. And as the legendary comedian and successful morning talk show host Steve Harvey once said, the boredom of normalcy and the numbness of mediocrity stiffens your passion. If you're happy being the average person that you are, then I'm glad that that's what you want to be. But if you're sick and tired of being mediocre, go out there and do something about it. And along the way, you have to tell yourself that you can't cry about what's on your plate when your main goal was to eat. Stay dedicated and stay focused on your end goal, knowing that the only one and the only thing that will stop you if it got into your way is yourself, which is why you shouldn't allow yourself to be the source of your own defeat. Once again, our class is among those who are seriously talented and dedicated. The only thing left is for us to take over the wheel. One of the examples in our class of a highly determined individual is Rowan. Rowan has been ordering food for us since grade 9. She was caught once and never again because she didn't give in to her loss along the way. She was dedicated to order that food, went and learned from her mistakes. Nothing got between her and her success. That is dedication, not fearing that you will lose, but outweighing the potential of losing with a vision of being successful. Another example is Charles, who has been asking for a senior video for over 3 weeks. He got so sick and tired of asking for a senior video that he went out and not made one, but two senior videos in one night. Again, that is dedication. That is a work ethic we should all strive to attain. These examples are just the comedic tip of the iceberg as to what our class is capable of achieving if we put our minds into the right path and seek the correct goal. You must set up the path towards success for yourself, because if you couldn't find the source of power that you hold, no one will. Exceptional diploma marks, honorable mentions, and all other extracurricular activity distinction awards go to prove the talent our class possesses. And that is my message to the class of 2020. It wouldn't be a speech without me thanking our teachers who have been by our side unconditionally through hardships, both academically and not. I would like to leave off my speech with a video made by a very special student. She has gathered numerous moments and compiled them into a little surprise video for the class of 2020.
To the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feel like December when somebody say your name. Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day, hey. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, hey, hey. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. Memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I never felt so lost, and I felt all of the hatred was too powerful to stop. Now my heart feels like an ember, and it's lighting up the dark. I'll carry these torches for ya, and you know I'll never drop. Yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back
back your memories, bring back memories, bring back your memories, bring back memories, bring back your. Memories, bring back memories, bring back your.
Okay, maybe it was like an.
Give me a second, I need to get my story straight. My friends are in the bathroom, getting higher than the Empire State. My lover, she's waiting for me just across the bar. My seat's been taken by some sunglasses, asking about a scar. And I know I gave it to you months ago. I know you're trying to forget. But between the drinks and subtle things, the holes in my apologies, you know, I'm trying hard to take it back. So if by the time the bar closes and you feel like falling down, I'll carry you home tonight.
Many days fell away with nothing to show.
and the walls kept tumbling down in the city that we love. Great clouds all over the hills, bringing darkness from above. But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like you've been here before? How am I gonna be an optimist about this? How am I gonna be an optimist about this? We were caught up and lost in all of our fights. If you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like you've been here before? How am I gonna be an optimist about this? How am I gonna be an optimist about this? And the walls kept tumbling down in the city that we love. Great clouds roll over the hills, bringing darkness from above. But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like you've been?
You look there.
Can hurt. Loving can hurt sometimes, but it's the only thing that I know. When it gets hard, you know it can get hard sometimes. It is the only thing that makes us feel alive. We keep this love in a photograph. We made these memories for ourselves, where our eyes are never closing, hearts are never broken, and time's forever frozen still. So you can keep me inside the pocket of your ripped jeans, holding me closer till our eyes meet. You won't ever be alone.
can keep me inside the pocket of your ripped jeans, holding me close until our eyes meet.
Through the phone, wait for me to come home.
From the class of 2020, thank you, Eamon, for this beautiful video.
Well, now we know who's most likely to start a YouTube channel for their biceps. Congratulations, by the way. We'd like to transition to the well-anticipated academic awards.
Ah, Riva, there are so many awards.
Yeah, how come our names are on all of them? Crazy.
I guess we took it all, huh? I mean, we knew we were amazing, but this is outstanding.
That had me cracking up, but I guess bad jokes really are our specialty, huh? Well, for real though, those are some amazing achievements. Our class really did everything above and beyond.
That's true, and everybody here deserves all the recognition for their contribution. We had some of the most amazing personalities this year.
I agree. So, without much delay, I'd like to call Ms. Abood back to the screen to present the academic awards for the class of 2020.
Now for the second award, it is a dedication award. This award goes to a student who has put in countless hours for the school. She has organized almost all of the events, starting from the desert trip, making the desert trip t-shirts happen, chaperoning the junior high trip, organizing the cultural fair, organizing all of the wellness activities for the junior kindergarten to grade six classes, has run errands for all of these events. She has represented Blyth Academy at Georgetown's Model United Nations Conference and has organized a senior trip and was even supposed to dedicate one of her vacations to volunteering in Cambodia. I'd like to give this award to Riva Pandya. And now for the academic awards. For English Language Arts 30-1, for semester one, the most improved student goes to Aryan Rahman, and the best student goes to Riva Pandya. For semester two, the most improved student goes to Abdal Al-Manai, and the best student goes to Arush Shah. For Math 30-1, semester one, the most improved student award goes to Rawanda Ataya, and the best student award goes to Sarah Nashbat. And for semester two, the best student award goes to Ashraf Mahdi. And for Math 30-2, the best student award goes to Aryan Rahman. In Biology 30, semester one, the most improved student award goes to Abdullah Al-Naimi. And the best student award goes to Ayman Zera. For semester two, the most improved student award goes to Maria Idarus, and the best student award goes to Sarah Nashbat. For social studies 30-1, the most improved student award goes to Noor Shadid, and the best student award goes to Sarah Nashbat. For semester two, the most student was Rwanda Taya, and the best student was Abdallah Al-Abadi. For chemistry 30, semester one, the most improved student award goes to Rwanda Taya, and the best student award goes to Ilyas Al-Tabarani. For semester two, the most improved award goes to Maria Idarus, and the best student award goes to Sarah Nashbat. For PE semester one, the most improved student goes to Ilyas Al-Tabarani, and the best student award goes to Abdallah Al-Abadi. For semester one art, the best student award goes to Noor Shadid. And for semester one Arabic, the best student award goes to Ashraf Mahdi. And for semester two, the most improved student award goes to Noor Shadid, and the best student award goes to Ashraf Mahdi. And for computer technology, the best student awards goes to Ilyas Al-Tabarani. And for second semester Islamic, the best student award goes to Abdallah Al-Naimi. And for semester two drama, the most improved student award goes to Isabel Holmstrom. And for semester two, psychology 30, the most improved award goes to Omar Musa, and the best student award goes to Noor Shadid. Congratulations to all of our students and all of their great achievements. We are all so proud of you and everything you have done, and good luck in your future.
These achievements could be the beginning of something great for our generation's future.
This year, school ended quite unexpectedly, and I think we can agree we never had the chance to express our gratitude and our final goodbyes with the teachers who shaped us into who we are today.
Thankfully enough, we live in a time where we have the power to stay connected despite physical boundaries.
Regardless of how much may have seemed to lack this year, I think we can all agree that our teachers have always absolutely been the best.
Their constant support and efforts to help us succeed have never wavered.
So, for one last time, I would like to call the teachers for a couple last words of advice before we go into the real world.
Hello, grade 12s. Congratulations on your graduation. I wanted to send out congrats to you. You all worked very hard to get here, and I'm honored to have been part of this journey with you, a small part of it. I respect and care about each of you. I was looking at the class list earlier today, and as I'm looking at all your names, I'm in awe of what good human beings each of you are. And so I just want to say thank you for being a part of my journey with Blyth. And I just want to say, when I think of your cohort of grade 12s, I think of mature, respectful, funny, playful, positive, diplomatic, genuine, even with your struggles. All of you shared with me bits and pieces of yourselves this year. And whether that was your stresses, your angers, your fears, your anxieties, your humor, your sarcasm, you are champs and so, so smart and genuine at this, being this human thing. Whether you're academically smart, socially smart, ethically, morally, you're all brilliant, and I wanna say thanks for just, yeah. Thank you for your patience with me. This was a learning curve for me. Eamon, you should call Alberta and get a job. I don't know what I would have done without you in my corner this year, so thank you. To the ladies, the grade 12 ladies, I don't know if you've ever heard of the statement, blasting through the glass ceiling, but I hope you crash through the glass ceiling. When I think of the grade 12 females in your cohort, I think of strong, powerful, brilliant, sassy, sarcastic. You all have powers. Don't let anyone mess with your powers. Protect your powers. And if anyone ever disrespects you, get rid of them. Okay? To the gentlemen, grade 12 men, you guys are true, true gentlemen. And I'm in awe and wow of how all different you are all, but you're all so kind and respectful and humble and fun and approachable. And thank you. I'd be honored if my son was anything like you guys. Thank you, grade 12s. I have loved chasing you down the halls, some of you, begging some of you to complete your online classes, bribing you to complete your classes, yelling at you. Thank you. You have given me joy. In my 20 years working with teenagers, I've never worked with a group of young people that have just been so awesome. I wish you all health, happiness, balance, peace, and I respect you, and I wish you all the best next chapter, and I hope our paths cross again. Take care. Namaste.
Hi, this is Juanita McNeil, your math, physics, and science teacher. I'm just sending you congratulations on your graduation. I know it's been a difficult year for you, but I wish you all the best. You're going to have lots of great memories of Blyth Academy, and I hope your life is full of love, luck, and laughs. Bye.
Congratulations, class of 2020, and the best of luck to every single one of you.
Congratulations, Blyth graduates. Certainly one to remember. I hope you start each day believing in dreams and never doubt that you were made for great things. You see, the world is as big as your dreams, so never stop dreaming. I wish each and every one of you all the best.
Hi, graduates of 2020. I'm sure it must be exciting and a little scary entering this next chapter of your lives. Really, our world needs more brave, courageous, and positive people, so go and let your light shine. Share your amazing gifts and talents with the world. Congratulations.
Congratulations, 12 graders, on your graduation. Definitely well deserved. I want to wish you a happy and safe summer, and all the best for your next adventure. Take care. Bye.
Hi, grads of 2020. Congratulations. My name is Miss Goche and I teach kindergarten, and I can promise you it only gets better from here. I know it's been a crazy year, but keep looking up. It does get better from here. Best of luck wherever the next step and chapter might be.
Hey everyone, I just want to send a big congratulations to all the grads of 2020. I'm so proud of you for making it to this moment in your lives and for the obvious reason of getting through this crazy school year. So just take a moment to be proud of yourselves for making it this far and enjoy.
Congratulations, you have made it. I do hope you get the chance to celebrate your amazing achievement so far. I'm sorry that it had to end in this way, but you guys are amazing. Wish you all the best in your future endeavors. Congrats.
Hey, grade 12 grads. It's your day today, so we have a little story for you from the Terrays, okay? Today is your day, so put on your gown.
In this case, of course, you'll head straight out of town.
It's opener there in the wide open air.
Out there, things can happen and frequently do.
To people as brainy and footsy as you.
And when things happen, don't worry, don't stew.
Just go right along, you'll start happening too.
Oh, the places you'll go.
Just a little story from us. Good luck, everyone.
Congratulations to all the Blyth 2020 graduates. You've certainly persevered through these challenging times, and I know that you guys are going to be doing great in the future. All the best to everyone, and take care. Bye.
Hi, graduates of 2020. Hope all is well. Mr. Gus here speaking to you from Canada. It's an honor to be a small part of your high school graduation in Doha, Qatar. It seems just like yesterday that you were sitting in on my grade 7, 8, and 9 social studies classes, and I can remember telling you that time goes by quickly, and in short order that you would be completing your grade 12. So here you are, young adults, ready to take on the world. You're graduating in times of difficulty, but when we emerge from this global pandemic, much like challenges in the past, you will be stronger and better prepared to face the unexpected, and you will even be more resilient. The future is still a blank canvas, and it is yours to create. I'm proud of all of you for your hard work and dedication, and I want to thank you for the respect that you have shown me as your teacher during the 6 wonderful years that we had together in Qatar. Take care of yourselves, be safe, and congratulations. Way to go.
Congratulations, grade 12s. I've had the pleasure of getting to know most of you, especially for those of you who hung out in the hallways outside my classroom. You know who you are. You're all amazing, compassionate, smart, respectful young men and women who are starting this next chapter in your journeys. Be willing to embrace wonder, experience the unexpected, and go in unknown directions. I wish you all well as you start this journey. You've got this.
All our graduating grade 12s, I know this has been a challenging year and probably a graduation not like you would expect, but I hope you all grow from this. I hope you all learn from this and you go on to be the great and wonderful people that you're all capable of being. I miss you all. I miss seeing all your faces around the school, and I hope whatever life leads you next, you have success and joy in everything you do. Bye-bye.
Hello, everyone. I'm Mrs. Sada. I hope you are doing well. I miss you guys a lot, and I just wanted to congratulate you on graduating. Very well done, all of you. You should be so proud of your hard work. You are the leaders of this new generation, and I'm looking forward to seeing how far you go in your accomplishments. All the best. Good luck in your future. Stay in touch, and congratulations once again.
So, with COVID, the first thing that happened is I got stuck in Africa. I was there for a week by myself, and then I took 48 hours to get home. After that, I was in quarantine for 2 weeks. It's been quite the ordeal, but to be honest, the biggest thing that I regret after this is not seeing you guys graduate. You guys were my grade 10s, my first class of teaching when I first came in, and I can't believe that I'm not going to see you guys graduate. I wish you all the best of luck. You deserve it. You guys have been amazing. I've seen you grow up from these, your first high school experience, grade 10, not sure, to now young adults, and I know you're ready for the world. Have a great day, and I wish you the best of luck.
Hello, graduates. We're finally there. We finally made it. I bet none of us thought it would look like this, but hey, you guys are awesome. And you have been so great during this whole thing, and I want to thank you for teaching me daily. I have been able to learn from you. I hope you can all take everything that's happening and get inspired to become the next great scientist, the next great vaccine developer. Anything you want to become, you can do it. And I'm so proud of each and every one of you. And good luck. Stay in touch. And I hope to see you very, very soon. Have a great graduation.
Hi, grade 12. I just wanted to say good luck and well done on getting all the way to grade 12, and off you go to university next year. It's been a pleasure getting to know some of you, and I'm sure that for all of you, it's going to be such a wonderful experience. I wanted to say a very big well done and thank you to Aya and Omar for their wonderful performance at The Tempest. They're memories that I will treasure for a very long time. To Charles and Isabel and Riva, I do wish I had seen you perform on stage, but the talent that I did see was such a blessing to me. To all grade 12s, you are about to enter some of the best years of your life. So make sure that you get all of your studies done, you study hard, but you enjoy every moment of it, because they really are the best years of your life. So good luck, and I know you're gonna have wonderful futures ahead of you.
Congratulations, Blyth Academy Qatar graduating class of 2020. You finally made it. I just want to wish you all the best of luck in your future endeavors. And remember, like always, make good life choices.
Hey everyone, Mr. H here. I just wanted to say a couple of things to the graduating class of 2020. First of all, I wanted to thank you all for an amazing year. I've been a teacher for 12 years, and I can honestly say that teaching all the grade 12s this year was one of the highlights of my whole career. You guys were amazing, and it was so much fun being your teacher, being in class, being online for some of us. Since the lockdown, but you guys are amazing. I just want to thank you for an outstanding year. Secondly, I want to congratulate you all on an exceptionally successful school year, and of course on graduating and completing high school. I know the circumstances with the COVID lockdown and everything kind of suck for celebrating that, and that is too bad, but I want you to really think about the fact that when you started this journey so long ago, you were 5 or 6 years old, you were literally a child, and now you're coming out an adult, and you know, high school graduation is as much about that rite of passage into adulthood as it is just completing courses. And so I hope that even though the lockdown is dampened things like, you know, having a grad and stuff like that, really take the time to appreciate what you've accomplished and what you've been through and where your life is going. It's a huge deal. It's super important. And, you know, I'm happy and proud of all of you for making it this far. And of course, the last thing I want to say is obviously, I wish you all well in your future endeavors. I hope to hear from you guys. We're going to be back in Qatar next year. So hopefully with the COVID thing going away, hopefully, we can, connect up or at least stay in contact with email or something. I would love to hear where you all end up and all your next adventures in life. So, yeah. And truly, I hope at some point our paths get to cross again, because you are all amazing. So thank you for all that, and I wish you all the best. Take care.
Hello, graduates. Congratulations on making it through your final year of high school. You're now moving on to bigger and better things.
We wish you all the best in your future endeavors and believe that you are all going to accomplish beautiful and great things. Take care and all the best.
Congratulations, grads of 2020. Best of luck with everything in your future. You guys are awesome. Woo!
Hello, grads 2020. I just want to wish you luck on whatever path you decide to take. Know that you will have ups and downs, and you will probably end up in very different places than you thought you would. That's all for the best. It's all normal. It's all wonderful. So, I leave you with this quote from Dr. Seuss. Wherever you fly, you'll be the best of the best. Wherever you go, you will top all the rest. Except when you don't, because sometimes you won't. Good luck.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I am so proud of all of you guys, and the amazing things that you've done this year and how far you've come and how much you've grown in this year. If there's one piece of advice I can give you, it's that life starts at the end of your comfort zone. So make sure that as you leave Blyth and enter the real world, that you step outside of your comfort zone always. Because the best things in life happen when you're uncomfortable. Good luck to all of you. Please keep in touch. And from the bottom of my heart, the greatest congratulations. Sometimes I knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not
know it, but these are the moments that... Well, that was just heart-touching.
Elias, are you crying? Because me too. That was just beautiful. Thank you so much, teachers of Blyth.
Indeed. Thank you, not only for those inspiring words, but also the mentoring over all the years.
Well, I can't believe it. It's time.
We had many wonderful memories that we made over at Blyth Academy Qatar this year, and those will be cherished in our hearts forever.
We are now officially graduated seniors, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to ask you to move your virtual tassel from one side to the other. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Ready to go out into the real world and change it for the better?
On this note, we would like to conclude the Blyth Academy Class of 2020 virtual graduation ceremony.
Thank you for joining us in celebrating our seniors' success.
That's all, folks.